So very good morning students. We are starting with the next chapter of standard 11th, which is 1.3, the call of the soil, ascent of rice. So before beginning the chapter, as usual, we are going to solve some icebreakers, which will give you a brief and informative information regarding the chapter. So discuss the following with your partner and complete the following sentences. One is done for you, the activity. A. Before eating apples brought from the market, I wash and peel them off just to clean harmful pesticides sprayed on them. So before whichever type of fruit nowadays, or prior to this, whichever fruits or vegetables used to bring from the market, we usually clean them with water, okay, and then we peel them off just to clean the harmful pesticides or any types of chemicals which are sprayed on them. In a farmer's market, we find greens, we find spices, fruits, vegetables and livestock. So livestock here is the hens or the different types of cattle which are around, okay, or eggs or any products which are related with them. So food adulteration means adding substances that increase the volume or quality of a particular food item. So food adulteration is done to just increase the volume of a particular XYZ type of any food item. Organic food is grown by using natural fertilizers. So organic fertilizer means this natural fertilizers are those things such as the organic compost, a mix of the remains of animals, maybe plants, maybe vegetables. Then there is human waste, both urine and feces. Then is animal waste, that is both urine and feces of these animals. Next is complete the following web diagram. Rice varieties available at the grocer's shop. So which types of varieties are present, which some of us know that there is a type of rice known as kolam, then ambe mohar is there, indrayani is there, and then we have basmati. So let us discuss the next question. So the next question is, find out from your grandparents or parents the names of the vegetables and fruits they had eaten in their childhood, and mention how the vegetables and fruits are different from the ones today that you have today. So this particular question can be solved in two ways, that one, you can solve it on your own, and second, I have solved for you. So a few vegetables and fruits such as the banana. The shape is small, oval type of the shape is there. The color of the bananas that I used to eat in my childhood was small, and they were yellow and brown, and the taste used to be sweet. So the bananas that we find nowadays in the markets are very large actually. So the next type of fruit is the mango. It used to be oval, small, round. The colors used to be green, yellow, orange, sometimes reddish, and the taste used to be sometimes sweet and sometimes sour. Then the next is the potato. So potato is used to be small and oval. The colors used to be brown, and the taste used to be somewhere between sweet and salty. It was not sour, but the taste used to be somewhere between sweet and salty. So the next question here is, you might have learned about organic farming. Make groups and discuss the difference between conventional farming and organic farming and write it down. So conventional farming is that what the farmers practice nowadays, and organic farming is that which the farmers used to practice many years ago, and some of them are still doing it. So what is the difference between conventional farming and organic farming? Let us see that. So the next question is, these are few points which I have tried to mention here. The first is that it produces in conventional farming is mostly the aim is to produce more of everything, whatever they are going to sow, they are trying to produce more in that. In organic farming, the production is very less. So what do you say, the amount is very less that is produced, not very less but quite less in compared to the conventional farming. Then less manpower or labor, that means it requires very less effort to do this kind of farming. Organic farming needs much more labor or manpower. So the use of pesticides and fertilizers is an excess in conventional farming because they have to produce much more than required. But in organic farming, only limited use of pesticides is done because just to save the plants from the different types of pest or insect, that is the main motto or main idea. So in conventional farming, it takes less time to harvest, but in organic farming, as less use of fertilizers is there, it takes more time to harvest. The crops are seasonal, they are only out in those particular seasons. Next, the conventional farming, the quality is average, it is just satisfactory quality. But if you go with the organic farming, the quality of anything that is produced is the best. So now we shall see the little information about the author, and then we shall begin with the explanation of the chapter. So as we have discussed in this particular icebreakers of this particular lesson, we have come to know, or we know, that this particular lesson is specifically about agriculture. It is somewhere related with the roots of man. And let us now see about the author or the writer of this particular chapter. So Venkateshwaran or Venkat Iyer, born in 1966. Venkateshwaran, that is Venkat Iyer, is a science graduate and a certified project management professional. So this particular person here is a science graduate, means he graduated from science, the field of science. He's a certified project management professional. So these people work with the companies and they are giving a particular project where they have to manage all the things in that. He last worked in IBM in Mumbai as a project manager for software implementation. So implementation here means the applications of the software. So he worked for the IBM, that is a very famous IT company. After 17 years in the IT industry, he quit in 2004 to live on his organic farm in the Pet village in Dahanu Taluka, Palghar district in Maharashtra. So this particular person was an engineer, okay, or a professional who left his job just to do organic farming. Organic farming here means everything which is natural. So nowadays people prefer over organic farming. Organic farming here means it did not maybe use any kinds of fertilizers or any chemicals to grow his crops, which nowadays many of people are trying to do that, because with the help of these pesticides and chemicals, people could increase their yield on a larger scale. But if you are doing organic farming, natural farming, without the use of such things, then your quality will be very nice, extremely nice quality, but the quantity wouldn't be as much as the hybrid ones. So he started his particular farming, organic farm, in the Pet village, which is in the Dahanu Taluka, and this it is in the Palghar district, which is close to Mumbai, that is Maharashtra. So his book Moong Over Microchips traces his transition from techie to farmer over a period of 15 to 17 years. So initially he was a techie, means he was a person who had a great knowledge about technology, modern technology, software, hardware, a person who was an engineer, we can say a software engineer maybe. And then how he became a farmer from Moong Over Microchips. So this is a really wonderful name for any kind of book. So over a period of 15 to 17 years, there was a transition in him. Transition here means a change in him. So it was not an easy task for him. It was not a career change, but a lifestyle change I was looking for. He was not looking for a career change. Many of us people, we go from techie to farmers because we just want to earn a nice livelihood or a better career option. Many of us tend to change from farmers to techie. So this was a very rare case. Back in maybe 1980s or 1990s, where a person who is a techie, he wants to become a farmer. But nowadays you see, this is really a very sad thing for us, that most of us coming from a farmer family or farmer background, we don't want to become farmers. We want to become someone who knows about technology. So we are looking at a person who wants to become a techie himself. So he was not looking for a career change, but he wanted to change lifestyle for something better. He says about his decision to shift to the quieter environs of a village. Quieter means a much more calm place than the crowded city. He wanted to go to a place where he could do his work in a very quieter environment, like a village. He insisted on practicing organic farming from the outset. He was resolute in spite of numerous challenges which he faced. Resolute here means that he was somewhere determined that he will do this particular farming, organic type of farming, no matter how many challenges he was going to face, which he faced in fact. Today, not only does he deliver lectures on organic farming, but also joined hands with the organic farmers and NGOs working in the organic field to propagate organic farming. So today, not just he succeeded, he started giving lectures to motivate people to do organic type of farming, where he works with the NGO. And his idea is to propagate, propagate here means to spread the knowledge of organic farming to the future generations, to us maybe, our next generations which will be with us. So to ensure that the land at least is not ravaged while they try to make a living out of agriculture. So when when people are trying to follow the hybrid type of farming, it is seen that a number of pesticides, chemicals and harmful substances are used which somewhere ravage the land. Ravage means destroy the land, the quality of the land. The quality of the soil is somewhere destroyed in the race of getting better products, where the yield is too much, but after a time, of a particular time, after many years, the land which they use for agriculture gets started deteriorating, or it gets damaged, where the particular person may not have as much as he wanted to earn, or it may be even impossible for a particular person to earn. So let us now start with the chapter. We'll see the explanation first. The call of the soil, a scent of a rice. So this is the chapter where we will learn about a particular thing. Now we can see the call of the soil. The call of the soil here means the soil isn't calling here. This is something with a deeper meaning which I will discuss later by the end of the second explanation. A scent of rice. So you come to know that we are just going to learn about something which is related with the rice. So guess now the first crop, it was April 2004. I stood in the middle of the lush green field of moong, that is green gram, and looked around me. So the meaning of lush here means rich green field. Lush means when you look at that particular green field, you get a rich feeling that how beautiful or how vast it is. I was just before sunrise and the sky was turning a bright orange. The ground was damp and the leaves were shining with dew. Damp means the ground was dull, it was wet, maybe because of the dew. My bare feet were muddy as I walked around gingerly inspecting the plants. So damp here means wet and cool, and there was an inspection. He was doing an inspection of the ground. That is very early morning. We can say the time is between 5:30 and 6, where the color of the sky it changes to bright orange type of sky. And just before sunrise he was there and he was trying to inspect the mud. Maybe he was inspect the soil. My bare feet were muddy. Bare feet here means his uncovered naked feet. He wasn't wearing anything in his feet, neither socks, no shoes, nor sandals, anything. Just he was walking bare feet and he was inspecting gingerly. Gingerly means very cautiously, very carefully. He was looking at the soil, inspecting the plants. Around me were rows of chiku trees and a dense foliage of moong. At that point, I could not have asked for anything more. So around him were a lot of chiku trees and below a dense foliage. Foliage means the leaves of the tree or the plant. So he was just walking around where there were chiku trees and some moong plants. At that point, I could not have asked for anything more. The moong plants, not more than 2 feet tall, had green pods hanging out. Pods means pods. What do you mean by pods here? So pods here means a seed case. Means the moong plants had small pods and from which the seeds were just going to fall. The pods were not yet ripe and there was light fuzz growing on them. Means fuzz means little what is flowers were growing around them. There was still some time before the harvest. I felt exhilarated. There was a time of harvest. So harvest here means that whenever you plant some particular type of crop, the time when comes, you need to remove them. Remove them means when they are ripe and you start removing them, that is harvesting. So he felt very excited about that. Accelerated means he felt very So he felt excited about that yet the pods were not yet ripe and this is such a nice and wonderful land which he's walking and which is inspecting. I stood watching the sun rise above the towering trees across the fence and slowly made my way back to the house. A white structure in the middle of the greenery. I could not believe that I was the owner of this land and I was looking at my first crop. So he was just moving back towards his home. Now his home was a white structure in the middle of greenery, means everywhere, wherever he looked, wherever he could see, there were plants, there were moong plants, there were tall trees. In the middle of that particular land, he had his white house and he couldn't believe it because he was the owner of this land, this rich land where he could grow a number of things. And he was happy because he was looking at his very first crop. As a farmer at his first crop, he was very happy. After I had paid the advance money for the land, I thought I would have some time to get familiar with farming. So we are talking about a person's transition from being a techie or software engineer to a particular person who is a farmer. So he had brought a land with advance money, means he had given an extra charge for that particular land. He didn't knew anything about farming and the first day, or you can say the beginning of him as a farmer, and he sees his first crop, how would anybody feel? Anybody would feel great. But Moru Dada, the broker who got us the land, had other ideas. So the person who brought him this particular land, he was Moru Dada, another character in this particular chapter. He was keen that we plant moong at once. I was not prepared for this. I was still reading books and trying to figure out what we could sow and how we should go about it. So Moru Dada, the broker, had advised our writer that he should plant moong because he knew that it is the best season to sow moong. And he because he was yet figuring out that what should I do, what should I, if you are a new farmer or if you are anybody who's going to try things for the very first time, you try to read books, you try to figure it out, you try to find the information, okay, before going doing something very practically, you try to find information about it. But Moru Dada's advice, he listened to that advice and he just figured it out that let's try with moong. Moru Dada was quite firm. He said the season was right for sowing moong and the best seeds were available in Surat in the adjacent state of Gujarat. So we are talking about a place somewhere in Gujarat. He said that he advised that if you want this particular types of seeds of moong, then you should go to Surat. And he finally moved to Surat to get those seeds. I made a quick trip to Surat and bought around 10 kilograms of moong. Moru Dada returned his tractor to the plow to plow the land quickly and planted moong all over the place. So Moru Dada brought a particular tractor for him on money, renting on money, and he plowed the entire land and they started to plant moong there. A few days later, we were overjoyed to see tiny green leaves. I had never seen moong growing before and was thrilled at that sight. So we as people who are living in the metropolitan cities, most of us do not know where does these types of spices, these crops or these fruits come. Most of us do believe that all these things just come from a place known as a DMart or a big bazaar or somewhere like these places. But we are all wrong. Anybody who's farming and he knows, who will see the first crop growing in front of him, he will be accelerated, he will be very happy. So he had never seen moong growing before. Means any person of us who has never seen any particular type of crop growing, and when you see that particular crop, when you experience the growing of this particular crop, we will be very happy, we will excited about this particular type of experience. So as a young boy, when I saw the first of the hibiscus I had planted bloom at the railway quarters in the Ville Parle in Mumbai, I was grateful to have taken Moru's advice. So the very first plant that he saw as growing was a hibiscus plant that was in Ville Parle, which is in Mumbai, and he was very grateful for Moru's advice because as a farmer he had seen his moong growing. So the next thing Moru Dada wanted us to do was spray some pesticide on the plants. So the next thing that Moru Dada's one advice had went to fruit, being very fruitful, moong had started to grow. The next thing Moru Dada was wanting, he said that spray some pesticides on the plants. So he claimed that it would give a higher yield. So the pesticides are specific types of chemicals which are used to protect the plants from pests or insects, or you can use these pesticides to increase the yield or volume of the crops. So this was something he claimed that it would give a higher yield. This was something we did not want to do. So the writer did not want to use any type of pesticides or chemicals. We were clear that we would not use any chemicals and tried to explain it to him. He reacted as if we had suggested harakiri. So this particular reaction that Moru Dada gave was unexpected. He said that how could you grow plants without using these chemicals, and he suggested it is harakiri. So what do you mean by harakiri? A formal way of killing yourself by cutting open your stomach with a sword. So harakiri was actually not on the humans but was on the plants, that if you are not going to put any pesticides, then maybe the insects will eat the plants, or the plant may not be able to grow as much as it could be. So it took a lot of convincing to ensure that Moru Dada and his friends did not use any chemicals on the farm. They refused to understand how crops could grow without sprays. So we are living in the 20th century where maximum of us, we do not do organic farming. We try to increase our yield without looking at the quality. So the most of the farmers, they do not know that how without the use of chemicals, which can actually boost the volume of any type of plant, and without using them, how can we grow a number of crops? So contrary to what everyone had told us, nature did her job and she needed no bribes to get her work done. Contrary is in the opposite what everyone had said. Everyone said to spray the pesticides, but the writer refused to this particular thing, and he said that he needed, means nature did not need bribes. So a bribe is a type of what do you say, when a particular person gives a money to a particular person to do his work done, to do your work eventually very fast, to give bribes, not everyone. But he said that the nature did not needed any bribe. Soon it was harvest time, and we managed a respectable 300 kilograms. So harvest here, actually I have told that we had, it is the gathering of ripe fruits, vegetables or crops. So during the harvest time, they were able to get a respectable 300 kilograms. So it was a lot of confidence, an awful lot of moon had, and within a lot of confidence. So somewhere everything just changed out to be as per the writer's wishes, that without using any pesticides or chemicals, he got a respectable 300 kilograms, an awful lot of moong, and with a lot of confidence. Now I was certain that the land was fertile and that it was possible to grow crops without chemicals. It was a major morale booster. Moral booster means to keep one's belief. So his belief was that without using any kinds of pesticides or chemicals, I could grow a lot of plants because the land was fertile, that land was rich itself, thus it needed no pesticides or chemicals. So here I end your first lecture. We shall meet in the next lecture, where I shall be explaining the part two of the lesson. So till then, goodbye and take care and be safe at your homes.